In this video, we're going to look at how we can have Safari close all of our open tabs on the iPad, including how we can have Safari do this for us automatically. Now, if you're not familiar with who I am, I'm Dan Wasink from Dan's Tutorials. I create easy-to-follow video tutorials for the Mac, iPad, iPhone, Apple Watch, and Apple TV. You can find my videos at danstutorials.com. All right, let's get back to Safari and how we can close all of our open tabs. Let's go to my iPad. Now, before we get started, I first want to mention that I am using iPad OS 16. So if you're using a different version of iPad OS, it may work a little different. All right, let's see how this works with Safari on the iPad. Let's go and close my open tabs. To do that, what we first need to do is go over to Safari. Now, when we're looking at Safari, you're going to see that I have a number of different tabs here. I believe I have about 15 tabs. What I would like to do is close all of these tabs. In order to do that, all we have to do is just go over to the upper right-hand corner where these two squares are. And when I long press on it, or long click, if you have a smart keyboard, you can just long click with the trackpad. What you're going to see is close all 15 tabs. This is going to close all of the tabs, including the tab that I am on. Now, I can also just close this single tab, and when I do that, it's going to close this one tab and keep all the other ones open, so I'll end up with 14 tabs. Let's go ahead and do that. And now, when I long press on this, you're going to see that I now have 14 tabs. Now, let's say I wanted to close all of the tabs but one. Maybe I want to keep this tab open and I want to close all of the other tabs. How can I do that? Well, in order to do that, what we do is we go back up to our two squares and now we just click on it or tap on it. We do not long press. So I click on it. It opens up all of my different tabs here. I find the tab that I want to keep open. I wanted to keep open my ESPN here. And now when I long press on it, you're going to see the option to close the other tabs. When I select this, it's going to keep my ESPN open, but it's going to close all of my other tabs. So let's go ahead and do that. And now we can see we have one tab, and it's ESPN. Now, in addition to that, we can also have Safari close our tabs for us automatically after a certain period of time. In order to do that, we need to go to our Safari settings. So I'm going to swipe up, and we need to go to our Settings app. When I tap on this, I swipe up on the left side until I find Safari. This is where I have all of my Safari settings. We're looking for, I'm going to swipe up here, what we're looking for is Closed Tabs. And you're going to see that mine is set to close the tabs after 1 month. So if I have not visited a site in 1 month, what it's going to do is close those tabs. You can set this to be manually, so then it will never close any tabs, and then you can use those little tricks that I showed you earlier in the video. Or what you can do is set it to close the tabs after 1 day. That might be a little quick, but you can also set it for 1 week, and my favorite is 1 month. If I haven't visited a website after 1 month, I want to have Safari automatically close that tab. So that is how we can have Safari close our tabs, including close all of our tabs, or what we can do is close a single tab. We can also keep a single tab and close all of the other tabs, and then we can also set Safari to close our tabs automatically after a specific period of time. You do this in Safari settings. So that's how we close our open tabs in Safari on the iPad.